Atomist, Undo, Atagila, Bendis, Diana, Elapha, Hecate, Or, Elage, Crew, Luna, Phoebe, Selene. But not as dark and daring as me. I am Dionysus, the jewel in the rough of both of me. Mark me, this story is true. This is the tale of my evolution. My transformation from puny human to mythical lunar god. And someday you might all evolve. So full of me and be tangled up in my terrifying wake. Someday you will all luminesce from above as the stars ignite in the heavens. But today is not that day. Today you are only human. And I soar above you as a celestial gamma hue, perceiving from the sky. Any resistance to me will only deepen your anguish and make you more meaningless and weak than you already are. So spare me your epic platitudes and just accept the inevitable. I will drive my point into your mind. Drive it down. The act of recalling these events to you. The events of when I was a lowly human. Of when I was mortal. Of right before I was embraced by the mythic cosmos above. Will distort and darken your tender psyche and make cause bleeding from your eyes and ears if you are lucky. One day, about a year ago, when I was still a fucking human, while walking back from my favorite coffee shop in Capitol Hill, Coffee Messiah! Even though the owner was kind of a dick to me, oh well, this fucking coffee was good anyway. And women sporting long billowy scars and disjointed velvet visages. Headsets gained cool further the already frigid air, stone and frozen. They targeted me, I was targeted, and someday they will target you. Oh, but pray to the upper gods that they will drain the red hot lava of mortal light blood from your veins and raise you to the conflagrant electric sky. Your soul's been getting fired into nuclear tentacles, stretching to infinity. The Stygians pulled me into an alley and strapped my face, causing me to spill my fucking coffee. Long fruit burning and spraying up, refracting and glistening from the streetlights. The last one blow I would ever see as a mortal. They boasted to me that they could bring me to the way, join me to the truth, and show me a life of brotherhood and sisterhood and purpose. Lies! Then they held me down, slapped me further, pulled my head back, and forced a strange drink down my open throat. They called it the nectar of capitulation and submission. It tasted like pentafowl and copper, and it made me shiver and pass out. And I lost time, a lot of time. I woke up violently, what seemed like days later. It was, from the looks of things, could only assume was a drafty abandoned motel room in a drafty abandoned motel somewhere on Earth. Eyes still blurry, ego waking consciousness shocking me awake. Can't see much yet, trying to see. Blurs and zigzags everywhere, turning with me, following my eyes. Rainbow aura staring back, then turning away. A tiny stream of dust glow invading the room from the torn window shades. Just a ray of light piercing the darkness. Acrid smoke and the stench of fumatory clouding the claustrophobic air. I'm strapped to a hospital gurney. Fuck, what the fuck? I jolted up my neck as best I could. I spasmed and vomited. The anesthesia was wearing off. They must have given me anesthesia. It feels like I've been out for days. I squinted my intrusive to my ears. Whispering knives, intruding. She told me they were hoping it was a tumor, a genetic condition. Something that would be the reason I didn't trust in God. But the cries and the tears from before, she added, were not because they found something wrong with me. No, no, it was because they could find nothing wrong with me. Not a thing. There were no obvious physical or psychological reasons for my disbelief. They just couldn't understand it. It didn't make sense to them. She looked puzzled and said she felt pity for me as she gently caressed my forehead. A soft drag of a bony, grimy hand that ended with a hard pinch to my cheek. I asked her why. She said it was because I believe in nothing. She said she couldn't save me, but I was cursed by her god. Whatever, these people are fucking crazy. She pulls out a key from a rusty lab coat, stained with blood and mustard, and unlocks the chain, tying my hands to the gurney rail. I jerk my hands back. She tells me I need to beg her God for forgiveness. Then everyone in the room starts chanting, he believes in nothing, he believes in nothing, he believes in nothing. Then, as if prompted by a silent bell, everyone filed out of the room, out into the desolate, barren wilderness. The loose screen door announcing the exit of each, chanting columns of outside, music of the saints. No, but a tired chorus of the defeated. Time passed. Then, almost drained of all human energy, I managed to crawl outside onto a windswept desert. I began shouting at the sky. The medical crew, they were marching away blindly, as was most certainly their custom, and almost out of sight. And now, by my mind, I am world free, and by theirs, I am long gone. Good for them. I wish them the worst, and in the worst way. I have to beg God. What? Beg God for what? Nothing. Where do they get that? What are they talking about? They don't know me. Who are you people? What do you mean? You actually believe in this shit? No! Don't save me! Don't include me! I'm not joining! Who are you people? Do you think any of this is real? You made all this up! This is from you and your sick stupid books! So then, I don't believe in you! Grow up! Get a life! I don't believe in your fairy tales! And you know what? I don't think you do either! Do you want to control me? No! Then set me free! I'm not going to submit to your god! I won't submit to anyone! Just set me free! Why can't you leave me alone? I don't want to know your god! Fuck your god! And fuck you too! I believe in me! I am a person who can do anything. It's up to me. If you can't prove your god exists, then go and find something else to do with your life. Why are you wearing that stupid costume? Do you think your god cares? I'm laughing! You say the stars tell a story, but the stars in the sky are just the stars in the sky, and the moon is just the moon. But oh, how I'm drawn to it. The sun is warm and the sun is real. Did God speak to you? Because God did not speak to me. And you know what? I don't think God spoke to you. I think you're lying. I think you're lying because you're afraid. You are the only one who doesn't hear. But what if no one else is hearing it? And what if everyone is afraid? And what if everyone is lying? Lying! Give a family ties, did they deserve it? What a God's fucking plan? Maybe you can ask your God. Babies die. Maybe your God didn't bless them either. It's for nothing. Do you care who I love? Fuck you. Do you care how I love? Fuck you. Do you care when I love? Fuck you. Do you want to hold my hand? Fuck you. Do you want to tell me what to believe? Fuck you. Your book sucks and so do you. I believe in me. I can do everything. I have a 360 degree reality as my canvas. And I will paint my future. My future without lies. I don't need to worship anyone or any god. I love my life. I want to be free. I will be free. Your religion is peace. Your religion is love. Bullshit. Besides endless stories of indiscriminate killing and subjugation of women and girls, your book also tells you to cut babies for God. What the fuck? That's so fucked up, sicko. Do you think that makes God happy? Does it make you sick? It should. It makes me sick. You're sick. Get a life. Does God whisper to you? Does God tell you that you're right? I believe in me. I am alive and awake. I believe in life. And you can believe it. You can't stop me. I fuck who I fuck, and you can't stop me. I friend you, my friend, and you can't stop me. Tell your God to stop me. I'm waiting. Why can't your God say hi? This planet is weird. My body is mine and not yours. If I invite you, you'll share it with me. Otherwise, stay the fuck away. Keep your gun away from me. Keep your gun away from my body. Keep your gun away from my kids. Keep your gun away from my mind. God will choke on the truth. God will choke on my truth. I am love and I am compassion. If I drown, will I wake up? I don't know. Yes, please, but if no, then no. If you drown, will you shut up about your God? Please and thank you. If you don't approve of me, please fall off the earth. I am not in your club. I am in mine. I am the leader. I am the guru. I am the savior. I'm the prophet. I'm the next step in human evolution. I believe in the sun and the moon and the stars. I believe in me. I believe in reality. And I believe in life. And even though you're everywhere, swarming around me, trying to shame me, trying to suffocate me, lying to suffocate me, trying to demonize me, trying to vilify me, I will survive you. There are more like me. There are more like me than you know. There are more like me than you could possibly imagine. There are more like me. There are more like me. And at the very moment I shouted these last words, the night fell. Semi-dust skies curled open above me. And all of the wispy clouds and golden rust of sunset evaporated before my eyes. Perhaps the gods felt pity for me, for the abuse I had taken in the hands of the religions and their fanatical followers. Then, grinding on the Astraeus wind, a massive shadow started coursing along the desert floor. I looked up, I saw it, it flew from above. A bird of fire, a crystalline alchemist, hurling a thunderous storm of sound and light and fury, sleek and magnificently malevolent, to simultaneously roil and use euteric. A shower of burning iridium, alive with fire. Suddenly, a shower of green and golden metallic and killing sound fell onto me from the icy dark Alcan house. Music more beautiful than any I've heard before. I wanted to die. I needed nothing, nothing more. That sound was everything to me. Then, a thunderous voice, likened to a mountain of copper skimming across an ocean of light. It said, bring all of your dreams to me, for I am a helper and a fixer. A fixer to an end. This is the magic. For the music heralded by the Alcan House gifted me the power to transcend humanity, to reach higher, to exist on a higher plane of being, to touch the gods, to become a god. And then again, there are none like me, none like unto my power, for my pull is fierce and omnipresent. You can feel me in your oceans, in your sleep, in your wounds. For I encompass the whole of the moon, the breadth and the depth, the craters and the tunnels, the sharp diamonds, the rugged edges, the beauty and the sadness, the starlight from without and within.